have an idea.
Good enough.
As expected.
Useful. So obvious.
This is my duty.
Yeah.
Child's play.
Yeah.
You're soft. I cannot lose.
Yeah,
you saved me.
Choice.
I must stay focused.
Seems I prevailed.
Gotcha.
You're out of luck.
You weren't ready. Have I improved some?
Get lost!
Can't afford to lose. A change for the better. Thank goodness we're allies.
You're a big help.
Here we go.
You're amazing. Stay focused.
I'll cut through. I'll go.
Move carefully.
Aye, aye!
Go!
Too slow.
This is my duty.
Here goes.
What should I do?
I'm on it.
Ready.
Oh!
I did what I had to.
I owe you one.
You're a big help.
Quite helpful.
Thank you.
Thanks.
So, you think you can take the lance from me, huh? I'll kill you. I'll kill every last one of you!
Why have you come, you crest-bearing fool?
I'm here for the Lance of Ruin, Miklon. Hand it over. I don't want to humiliate you, but I will.
Hurry up and die already. If not for you, if it hadn't been for you...
Shut up! I'm so tired of hearing that. You've always blamed me for something that isn't my fault.
Not bad for your kind. A bunch of spoiled, rotten children.
What the hell?
Damn, look at that!
I'm out of here! Hold on! What the? Miklon! Is that you?
That form. Oh my. Is this your first time fighting such a thing? Then listen well to what I say. An evil power has caused them to grow quite large. Their life force is beyond a mortal like yourself. You cannot win unless you fell them twice, or even thrice. Even if you've cornered one, you cannot let your guard down. Those things are even worse when threatened. Can you see that barrier? It is surrounded by great power. You must break through to fight that thing. A strong attack or gambit might help to break through more quickly. If you can break the barrier, that power will have nowhere else to go, and that will likely cause confusion for that thing. It cannot counter while confused, which means that is the best time to attack. If you break down all of their barriers, not only will they be confused, they will not be able to move for a short while. Without the power flowing around them, they will not be able to restore their barriers. You might even be able to get something from them. They have such might that they will not fear you alone. but a battalion could prove useful on that front. Attack them with a gambit to draw their attention and force them to target you. Be on your guard when they have realized their full power. The damage caused at times like that is not contained to just one spot. Once they have charged some power up, their barriers will be restored. You really must pay close attention to those things. Distract them with a gambit, or just take them down before they can attack. In any case, think carefully before you act. But you should be conquering that thing instead of talking to me. If you're out of questions, get over there and fight!
So, this is the power of a hero's relic. To create such a sinister beast. It has gone too far. I fear all we can do now is put an end to it.
Give it my all. Predictable. It's time.
down.
Goddess, the beast is gone, yet Miquelon and the Lance remain.
It's over. Let's retrieve the Lance and leave this place.
Miquelon, my brother.
Changed. It was as though that lance was swallowing him whole. Upon that sight, it makes sense that your students were upset. I wonder if those relics truly hide such power. Yet even still, that power seems familiar. That form as well. As one who wields the sword of the Creator, does that mean you possess that power too?
Professor, you have returned. The goddess is indeed generous with her divine protection. I have already heard Gilbert's report about what happened. See to it that you keep what transpired at the tower to yourself. People would lose faith in the nobles should rumors spread of one using a relic and transforming into a monster. All regions of Fodland would fall into chaos. We must avoid that at all costs. Please ensure the students who accompanied you understand that as well. Have I made myself clear? His transformation into a black beast was nothing short of divine punishment from the goddess. Punishment for someone arrogant and foolish enough to use a hero's relic even though they were unworthy and unqualified. If someone without a crest were to wield the relic you possess, they would likely meet the same fate as Miquelon. You, however, have been chosen. You are worthy of wielding the sword of the Creator, so there is no need to worry. The Church will formally return the lance to House Gautier, if you would. You have my gratitude. I can see that I was right to trust you with this. Please report back. I will tell you of your new mission for the coming moon at that time.
Is your meeting over, Professor? I was just thinking about something. Professor... The possession of relics and crests has been highly valued in Fargus since ancient times. It's far from uncommon for someone to lose their ability to lead their house because they don't bear a crest. Just like Miquelon. It happened to my uncle as well. The eldest child of the king, and yet he never ascended to the throne. All families whose bloodlines carry the crests of the Ten Elites are much the same. But House Gautier takes it a step further and absolutely requires an heir who possesses a crest. To that house, the power of crests is a necessity, not a luxury. House Gautier holds the most northern territory in the kingdom, and they have fought with the people to the north for many years. The head of that house is responsible for protecting that territory from fearsome invaders,
whom they keep at bay with the power of crests and relics. In exchange for that responsibility, they are granted special privileges within the kingdom. In a way, that said, ability cannot be measured by the possession of a crest alone. I believe that Margrave Gautier was wrong to disinherit Miquelon, simply because he did not bear a crest. Still, there is always a reason for why such customs stand the test of time. Imagine what this world would be like if no one placed any stock in crests. Bloodlines that carry crests would dwindle. The metaphorical blade used to oppose threats would eventually rust. This same argument has been made time and time again across the years. Both sides are at once right and wrong. I believe those with crests and those without should acknowledge the other's strengths and learn to respect each other based on personal merits. And that doesn't apply only to crests. The same holds true for lineage, race, faith, ideologies. If we could just accept each other and make mutual concessions one step at a time, perhaps... Who knows if that's even possible? Everyone has something that is unacceptable within them. I certainly do. And I'd wager you do as well. I wonder which is best, Professor. To cut away that which is unacceptable, or to find a way to accept it anyway?
Professor, you have done well to complete such a difficult task. You have shown exceptional skill in leading your students. I am forever grateful for the safe return of the hero's relic. Just as I expected, you have mastered the sword of the Creator. Now then, I shall tell you about your mission for the coming month.
Archbishop!
Setith, what troubles you?
Flayne is missing. I cannot find her anywhere. Professor, have you seen Flayne recently? I have searched everywhere. Where could she be? She may be in danger. Oh, no, no, no. What am I to do?
Calm yourself, Setith. Professor, we shall continue our discussion another time.